Nobody expected SpaceX to beat Boeing. Elon Musk proved them all wrong. But exactly what happened and how? Let's find out. Before that, we welcome you all to our YouTube channel. We post daily updates from the world of space. If you like our videos, make sure to subscribe to our channel to never miss out on any of our latest space-related videos. One was a venerable giant with a legacy in aerospace that stretched back more than 100 years and a role in every major moment in NASA's history. The other was a relative upstart that in its early days was derided as little more than a delusional billionaire's fantasy. No one thought Elon Musk's SpaceX would ever beat Boeing to space. Some members of the Congress even wondered why NASA would bother awarding contracts to two companies to build capsules to fly astronauts to the International Space Station under NASA's Commercial Crew Program. Just let Boeing do it. However, SpaceX appears to have won the competition. The launch of SpaceX's Crew Dragon capsule with astronauts aboard on Wednesday would be not only the first crewed launch to orbit by a private corporation, but also a major upset in a new type of space race. During the Apollo era, NASA was propelled to the moon by a Cold War space race with the Soviet Union. But today, companies are reenacting the roles of nations in competitions that NASA hopes will help recapture some of the past achievements. Assuming the launch is a success, it will mark the end of the era in which only government-owned spacecraft achieved such feats and represent another major step in the privatization of space. That SpaceX is making the transition, and not Boeing, emphasizes the dramatic nature of the change. The companies in public play down any tension. However, the competition has grown increasingly fierce over the years, especially as SpaceX evolved from a rich man's folly that no one took seriously to a disruptor that transformed the entire aerospace industry. In the beginning, SpaceX was largely dismissed as a long shot that would never achieve much. One industry veteran told me, "You know their rockets are put together with rubber bands and sealing wax," recalled Lori Garver, a former deputy NASA administrator who pushed the agency to outsource human spaceflight to the private sector. "It's not real, it won't fly. We had to be super scrappy," Musk once told the Washington Post. "If we did it in the standard way, we would have run out of money. For many years, we were week to week on cash flow." Within weeks of running out of money, it definitely creates a mindset of smart spending. Be scrappy or die. Those were our two options. Buy scrap components, fix them up, make them work. Boeing, by contrast, was used to the cost-plus contracts often used on big government programs, such as its Space Launch System rocket that allowed for greater expenditures in longer timelines. Still, building a spacecraft designed to fly humans is an enormous challenge, and both companies suffered setbacks and delays that pushed back the original launch date from 2017. SpaceX had two Falcon 9 rockets explode, and it struggled with the parachute system that slowed the spacecraft down as it flies back to Earth. Last year, its Dragon capsule was completely destroyed during a test of its emergency abort system. Since then, however, SpaceX has discovered the root causes of all the problems and fixed them, NASA says. Boeing, meanwhile, has continued to struggle. Last year, its test flight without any astronauts on board, its Starliner spacecraft, went terribly awry from the moment it reached orbit. The spacecraft's onboard computers were off by 11 hours, making the autonomous spacecraft think it was in a different part of the mission. Controllers on the ground had trouble communicating with it as well. Later, the company discovered another software glitch, one that would have affected the separation of the crew module from the service module. As a result, Boeing will refly the test mission, a flight it says would probably happen towards the end of this year, meaning its first launch with a crew wouldn't happen until 2021. Inside the company, officials were embarrassed by the setback. Another bit of bad news that followed the fatal crashes of two 737 MAX airplanes. It also triggered a role reversal. Boeing, once the trusted partner, was now under renewed scrutiny by NASA, which said it had been lax with its oversight of the company. NASA also said after initially giving Boeing a pass, the agency would perform a full safety review of the company, as it did with SpaceX after Musk was seen taking a puff of marijuana on a podcast streamed on the internet. One industry official said executives inside Boeing can't accept SpaceX is flying people first. "People are annoyed by Elon. How does this guy who smokes pot beat us?" said the official, who spoke on the condition of anonymity because that person was not authorized to speak publicly. "We have a lot of humble pie to eat here." Musk once told the Post that SpaceX was able to rise because the big aerospace companies didn't think it would ever amount to anything. They screwed themselves because they were just arrogant and complacent. Look, Boeing doesn't even get out of bed for less than $1 billion. Boeing's response was just as combative. At the turn of the 21st century, before Musk entered the space business, Boeing was building the International Space Station with NASA, where we've kept astronauts safe and continuously in orbit. While others talk about aspirations and hopes, we actually do things in space, and we will deliver on our commitment to America's journey to Mars. That's what we get out of bed for. Musk sued the Air Force for the right to compete for contracts, a risky move that annoyed some in the Pentagon. Musk also made a stink over the fact that ULA has a rocket engine manufactured by Russia. Lockheed and Boeing are used to stomping on new companies, and they've certainly tried to stomp on us. I think we have a shot at prevailing, but we're certainly in a small up and corner going up against giants. Ultimately, though, he settled with the Air Force and was able to compete, and since then has won a handful of Pentagon launches. Most recently, Boeing and SpaceX sparred over the Commercial Crew program when a NASA Inspector General report found that average cost of Boeing Starliners would be $90 million per astronaut, compared with $55 million on a seat on SpaceX's Dragon. "This doesn't seem right," Musk wrote on Twitter, adding, "meaning not fair that Boeing gets so much more for the same thing." Boeing pushed back hard against that report, saying it is a fact that our competitor receives contracts years earlier to develop a cargo vehicle that later served as the basis for their crew offering. Recently, when NASA announced it had awarded a contract for $1.79 billion to Aerojet Rocketdyne for 18 RS-25 engines for the core stage of the massive Space Launch System rocket Boeing is building for NASA, Musk lamented the cost. "SLS makes me feel sad," he tweeted. Last month, SpaceX notched another victory when it was chosen to be among the three companies awarded preliminary contracts to develop a spacecraft to land astronauts on the moon. Boeing was not among them. But when Boeing's Starliner was in trouble after it reached space last year, Musk's tone was markedly different. Having suffered through several failed crashes, he added a touch of empathy. "Orbit is hard," he tweeted. "Best wishes for landing and swift recovery to the next mission." What do you all think of this? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below. With this, we have reached the end of our video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again tomorrow.